الله الذي هدانا للإيمان وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، له الملك وله الحمد، يحيي ويميت وهو على كل شيء قدير، وأشهد أن محمد رسول الله بعث بالدين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله ولو كره المشركون. اللهم صلِّ وسلِّم وبارِك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلِّم تسليمًا كثيرًا. أما بعد، الله سبحانه وتعالى tells us in سورة الذاريات، أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، وذكر فإن الذكرى تنفع المؤمنين. If we reflect on the meaning of this ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling Prophet Muhammad and then telling us all after that, ذكر means remind. فإن الذكرى تنفع المؤمنين, the reminder is useful and good for the believers. Inshallah, today the reminder for us is about Surah Al-Fatiha. We read Surah Al-Fatiha minimum of 17 times a day, but how many during these times do we reflect on what we're reading? Do we understand the meaning of what we're saying and try to interact with it? الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم tells us لا صلاة لمن لا يقرأ الفاتحة. If you don't read al-Fatiha, you haven't prayed. So it's a core of the prayer is reading al-Fatiha. And as we said, we read it minimum 17 times a day. And الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم told one of the Sahaba, after the prayer, remind me to tell you the best surah in the Quran. And after the prayer, الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم forgot and the Sahabi didn't ask. So the Sahabi went out of the masjid and he remembered. So he came back quickly to ask الرسول, what is the greatest surah in the Quran? أعظم سورة في القرآن. So الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم told him, الحمد لله رب العالمين. Because they used to call the surahs with the first ayah, by the first ayah. So سورة الفاتحة used to be called الحمد لله رب العالمين because it starts with الحمد لله رب العالمين. And the رسول صلى الله عليه وسلم told him it is the greatest surah in the Quran وهي السبع المثاني والقرآن العظيم. It has seven ayat in it and it is the great Quran. سبحان الله. سورة الفاتحة which we read quickly trying to finish the salah quickly is the greatest surah in the Quran. And it has so many names. Al-Fatiha is one. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen is another. Surah Al-Hamd, because we praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Al-Shifa is Al-Cure. Al-Waqiyah is a protection. Al-Kafiyah is enough. Wa Asas Al-Quran, the base of the Quran. All these are the names of Surah Al-Fatiha. And Al-Shifa, the cure. A woman came to the Khalifa Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu and told him, my son is sick. Cure him. So he said, how could I cure him? She said, she had went to Osman ibn Affan and said, cure him. He said, how could I cure him? She said, well, Umar ibn al-Khattab used to read al-Fatiha on him and he's cured. So Osman ibn Affan read al-Fatiha and told him here, told her, here is al-Fatiha, but where is Umar? Because Umar, when he used to read it, he believed in his heart it would cure. So it would used to cure the child. Some of the Sahaba were traveling and they were at a non-Muslim tribe and the leader of the tribe got sick and they sent to the Sahaba to cure this leader. So they did, bargained with them, if we cure him, we give us some money, reward. And they agreed. So the Sahaba read on him Surah Al-Fatiha and he got cured. They came back to Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam and said, Ya Rasul Allah, we read Al-Fatiha on him and he cured and he gave us this reward. Was this right? He said, first, how did you know it was a cure? They told him, we had a gut feeling, it is. He said, well, you're right, and I will take a share of the money that you cured him with. So it is a cure. And how many of us try to treat our patients with al-Fatiha? I'm not saying with al-Fatiha alone, but because the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, tadawu fa inna li kulli da'in dawa, search for medicine and take your dawa, take the medicine. But when you take the medicine, you have to know it is Allah who is Shafi. It is Allah who cures, and you take it Bismillah, Rahman Rahim, in the name of Allah, and inshallah, it will cure. So this is Al-Fatiha. So إن شاء الله as we read الفاتحة and we reflect and we reflect on the great advantages of الفاتحة. So when we read it, Allah سبحانه وتعالى tells us in a hadith in Qudsi, I have divided the prayers between me and my servants. And the prayers here meaning Surah Al-Fatiha. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, if my servants say Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, Allah answers him back and says, my servant Hamadani Abdi, my servant have praised me and said Alhamdulillah, thank me. And then when we say Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Asna alayya Abdi, my servant have complimented me. And then when we say Maliki Yawm al-Din, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala answers back and says, Majadni Abdi, my servant has glorified me. Subhanallah. And then when we say Iyyaka na'budu wa iyyaka nasta'in, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, this is between me and my servant. And then when we say Ihdina as-sirata al-mustaqim, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, wa li'abdi ma sa'al, I will give him whatever he asks. All this dialogue is happening when we're reading the Fatiha in the prayer. But how many of us are focused when we read the Fatiha? Because this is a dialogue with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We're having a dialogue with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If we're talking to our boss, we focus and we say the words in focus because we want to show that we are we care and this is important to us. But when we're in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reading al-Fatiha, and as this hadith Qudsi shows, it is a dialogue between us and Allah, we say it and most time we don't understand what we're saying and we don't reflect on what we're saying. So inshallah when we pray, we reflect that this is a dialogue between us and Allah. As we said before, if you want Allah to talk to you, read the Quran, because the Quran is Allah talking to us. And if you want to talk to Allah, go in the prayer, start praying. So when we pray, we are in a meeting with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We start the meeting, we choose when we start the meeting, and we choose when we end it. And as I said before, in business, I make an appointment with an important person a month ahead of time, and when the time comes, he cancels the meeting and says, sorry, I got busy. But with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we choose the start and we choose the end. And we have the dialogue with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through Surah Al-Fatiha. So we should focus, because everything we need, Allah will give us. Allah will make things easy for us. This important meeting we look forward to, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make it easy and will make it successful. If we only we focus on our prayers and try to understand what we say. So inshallah, we'll go quickly through Surah Al-Fatiha. And the first ayah in Surah Al-Fatiha is Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. And Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim is an ayah in Surah Al-Fatiha, but we read it in other surah, even though it's not an ayah in other surah. It's only an ayah in Surah Al-Fatiha and an ayah in Surah Naml, where the letter was Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, the letter from Sulaiman to the Queen of Sheba. That's two places where Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim are ayats of the Quran. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, we start by in the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we have to understand it is the key for everything. When you want to enter something, enter a door or enter your car, you use your key. And Al-Fatiha is the key to facilitate everything. And when you're doing something, you're doing it in the name of Allah. If a manager sends an employee to ask for something, he says, I'm coming in the name of the boss, to give himself importance, to give so people can give him the attention. And it's the same thing for us. When we start doing something, we do it in the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we're talking to these things. If we're starting the car and we say Bismillah, we're talking to the car. And we have to understand, وَمَا مِنْ شَيْءٍ إِلَّا يُسَبِّحْ بِحَمْدِهِ وَلَكِنْ لَا تَفْقَهُونَ تَسْبِحَهُ. Everything praises Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But we do not understand their praise. But they do praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And as we know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells the mountains, Ya Gibal Awibi, the mountains, to praise Allah with Dawood alayhi salam. And as we know, Rasulullah alayhi wasallam said, Uhud, Jabalun yuhibbuna wa nuhibbu. Uhud is a mountain, we love and loves us, subhanallah. So everything interacts. We interact with nature, and when we do something, we start by Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. We're doing it in the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make it easier, to give us this importance. So here, and then if we want to, if something bad happens to us, we say Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. We are for Allah, and we go back to Allah. So here we're associating ourselves again with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah will take care of us. Yes, something bad happened, but Allah will take care of us. So when something bad happens to us, the first thing that should come to our mind is Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. We are with Allah, and we are for Allah, and we go back to Allah. But for us, most of us, when something bad happens, we think of a friend, a relative who is going to help us something, and then all else fails, we think of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we should start by the name of Allah, and if something happens, we put it back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So it is, Bismillah, is the key for everything, and when we start anything, we say Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. And then the next ayah is Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. Alhamdulillah, so thanking Allah, the Lord of the universe, and they define Al-Alameen is everything in existence except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah Rabbil Alameen. Everything in existence is Al-Alameen. And Allah is Rabb. And it didn't say here Ilah. Ilah is the one we worship. But Rabb is the one who provides, the one who takes care, the ones who helps. So Rabb is the word here, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala provides for the whole world and the universe. He takes care of everything. He's the one who's helping us all. So we start by Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. And subhanallah, when we go in the prayer and we listen to the Imam saying Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, subhanallah, it's the first thing that we say. We're thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we have to ask ourselves, what are we thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for? Maybe we're thanking him because we are praying, because maybe we are fortunate to be praying, because we were guided and we pray, because we took time out to pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for all the bounties he has given us. Subhanallah, I've just come from the Middle East where the environment is different. And as I walk in the streets and I see this beautiful green here and the cleanness, I say Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. How many of us thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for as-sama' wal-absara wal-af'ida? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, وَجَعَلَ لَكُمُ السَّمْعَ وَالْأَبْصَارَ وَالْأَفْئِدَ قَلِيلًا مَا تَشْكُرُونَ. Allah gave us the hearing, the eyesight, and the mind, but how many of us, little do we say Alhamdulillah. We are so busy when we drive our car, rather than enjoy the view and enjoy the scene, we're busy to get to our job or to our school, and we forget to say Alhamdulillah, and ask Allah, اللهم متعنا بأسماعنا وأبصارنا وأفئدتنا ما أحييتنا واجعلنا الوارث منا. That we might enjoy our eyesight and our hearing and our minds, subhanAllah. How many of us, when we look at this beauty, we say Alhamdulillah. But we are in the prayer, the first thing when we come in the prayer, we say Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. To make up for all this Alhamdulillah that we haven't said during the day, we get being busy. Alhamdulillah to cool us down and put us back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And so if we look at the discussion between Fir'aun and Moses and Fir'aun, Fir'aun asked Moses, وَمَا رَبُّ الْعَالَمِينَ? Who is رَبُّ الْعَالَمِينَ? The God of the whole universe. So Moses asks, answers, as it says in the Quran, قَالَ رَبُّ السَّمَوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضُ وَمَا بَيْنَهُمَا. It is the God of heaven and earth and in between them. رَبُّكُمْ وَرَبَّ آبَائِكُمُ الْأَوَّلِينَ. He's your God and the God of your fathers and your forefathers. Subhanallah, this is رَبُّ الْعَالَمِينَ. They tell us that Umar ibn al-Khattab had seen a young man in the masjid praying, and he was good. So Umar asked him, why don't you come and join me and be my companion, and I'll take care of you. So the young man asked Umar, it says in the Quran, الَّذِي خَلَقَنِي فَهُوَ يَهْدِينَ. Allah created and guided. Would you guide me? He said, I'll do my best to guide you. So he said, وَالَّذِي هُوَ يُطْعِمُنِي وَيُسْقِينَ. Allah feed me and give me drinks. Would you do that, Umar? He said, yes, I will do my best to feed you and give you drinks. So he says, Allah says, وَإِذَا مَرِضْتُ فَهُوَ يَشْفِينَ. And if I get sick, Allah will cure me. Would you cure me, Umar, if I get sick? He said, how could I? This is in the hands of Allah. He said, why don't you leave me with Allah then, rather than telling me, come, I'll take care of you, when you cannot really cure me if I'm sick, or take care of me if I'm sick. Leave me with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah will take care of me. This is Rabbil Alameen. when we say Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. Each one of us probably have bounties from Allah and favors from Allah that we don't count. If we just look at from we woke up in the morning till now, just waking up healthy, we should say Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. Alhamdulillah for our jobs. A lot of us complain about our job, not looking there is people who are jobless and would want this job. And we forget to say Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. Alhamdulillah, there's so much to say Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. And Adam, when in the first, when he was first created and the soul started going in him, he sneezed. And the first word he said was Alhamdulillah. The first word Adam said after he sneezed was Alhamdulillah. And the last thing we say, inshallah, in Al-Jannah, وآخر دعواهم فيها الحمد لله رب العالمين. The last thing in Al-Jannah, we say الحمد لله رب العالمين, inshallah. So it's the first thing that the humans have said, and the last thing they say in Al-Jannah, and we should not forget this, inshallah. And then the next ayah is Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. And as we know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أثنَ عَلَيَّ عَبْدِي, my servant has complimented me. And Ar-Rahman meaning his merciful for all his creatures. And Ar-Rahim is the mercy of Allah, but only an extra mercy for the believers. So Ar-Rahman, every creature has a rahmah from Ar-Rahman. And then Ar-Rahim is special mercy for the believers. In Hadith in Qudsi, the sun and the mountains and the seas got very angry. And they say, Ya Allah, you have provided so much for mankind and you have given them so much, and they do not thank you, they thank others. We're quickly to thank a human when he does something for us, but how many times we say Alhamdulillah and we thank Allah? And but we have to remember that the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, he who doesn't say, thank people will not thank Allah. Because thankfulness is a trait. And when you thank people, also remember to say Alhamdulillah and thank Allah. So the mountains and the sun and the oceans are fed up with mankind. They eat from the bounties of Allah, and Allah provides and they thank other. So what does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tell them? Leave me and my servants. Let me be with my servants. If they go back to Allah and do tawbah, I love them. And if they don't do tawbah, I am their doctor. I will treat them and I will cure them. Subhanallah. So leave me with my servants. دعوني وعبادي. So this is Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. And we all live in the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because if we were upon our acts, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as we know, that when a servant, somebody who worshipped Allah all his life, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told him in the day of judgment, go to Al-Jannah with my mercy, with my rahmah. But we are humans, we're arrogant. So he's like all of us, he says, Ya Allah, I worked so hard for this day. I want to see my hisab, I want to be accountable. Allah tells him, go with my mercy. He says, no, Ya Allah, we'll argue. وَكَانَ الْإِنسَانُ أَكْسَرَ شَيْءٍ جَدَلًا. We are like to argue always. Ya Allah, he says, Ya Allah, I did good all my life. I want to see my hisab. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to the angels, okay, start doing his accountability and start with his eyesight. Did he say Alhamdulillah enough for his eyesight? So they put the eyesight on one scale and put all his good deeds in the other, and the eyesight went down and the good deeds did not do anything. Why? Because we don't say Alhamdulillah enough. So we go to Al-Jannah with the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the Sahaba asked the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, even you, Ya Rasulullah? He said, yes, even me. We all go to Al-Jannah with the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we are thankful that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, سَبَقَتْ رَحْمَتِي عَذَابِي. سَبَقَتْ رَحْمَتِي عَذَابِي. The mercy of Allah is ahead of his punishment. And then after this, we say, مَالِكِ يَوْمِ الدِّينِ, the owner of the day of judgment. And some others in a reading, we read it Malik Yawm al-Din, the king of the day of judgment. And the scholar says Malik is stronger than Malik, owner is stronger than king, because an owner has the right to do whatever he likes with his property. A king rules, but he cannot sell your property. If it's justice, he cannot sell your property, even though he's the king of the land. He cannot do anything with the property because it's not really his. However, both readings are there. Malik Yawm al-Din, the owner of the Day of Judgment. and Malik Yawmuddin, the king of the day of judgment, and Yawmuddin is the day of Al-Hisab. Because here on earth, Allah, people call themselves kings, and yet they eat and they get sick and they die. But Yawmuddin, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, I am the king of all kings. Where are the kings of the earth? Where are those who call themselves kings? Subhanallah, they thought they're immortal and, but where are they? Subhanallah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Malik Yawmuddin. And Yawm here, the scholars tell us it is 1,000 years of what we calculate. As it says in the Quran, في يوم كان مقداره ألف سنة مما تعدون. It's a day that it's countable as 1,000 years from our count. This is Yawm al-Din. And in the day of judgment, the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says the poor people will go to Al-Jannah 500 years before the rich, half a day before the rich. And the rich ask why? He says, well, they have nothing to account for. The poor have nothing to account for, so they go straight to Al-Jannah. And this is where another hadith tells us that in the day of judgment, there is a parade of the poor Muslims going to Al-Jannah. So the angels tell them, hold on, there is Al-Hisab. They say, what's there to be accountable for? We are believers and we had nothing to be accountable for. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells them, let them go, let them to go to Al-Jannah. And that's why Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in his dua says, Allahumma ahyini ma'a al-masakeen wab'athni ma'a al-masakeen. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala let him live with the masakeen, is those who are poor, and send him in the day of judgment with the masakeen. Because the rich, we're going to be accountable for every penny we earned. All this money we earned and we're happy with, we're going to be accountable. Where did you spend it? How did you spend it? Did you pay a zakah on it? Did you do it for the sake of Allah or you wasted it? So here, Malik Yawm al-Din. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says all the children of Adam commit mistakes and the best of those who commit mistakes is those who ask for forgiveness. So let's pray to Allah and ask for His forgiveness. Alhamdulillah, wa shahadu an la ilaha illallah, wa shahadu anna Muhammad Rasulullah. We can carry on reflecting on Surah Al-Fatiha. And then we say, Iyaka na'budu wa Iyaka nasta'in. We tell Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is us, it is you that we worship, and it is you that we seek help and refuge. And here we don't say I, it is say we. We have to be as a community. We worship Allah together, and we seek the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala together. And that's where Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, إِذَا سَأَلْتَ فَاسْأَلُ اللَّهُ وَإِذَا اسْتَعَنْتَ فَاسْتَعِنْ بِاللَّهِ. If you ask, ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if you seek help from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And as we said before, the best story that summarizes this is a man had a dream or something telling him that there's a young man in a masjid and he should take money and supplies to him. So he goes to that masjid and taking money and supplies and see a young man raising his hand to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And so this man gives this young man the money and sings and tell him, son, you seem a good person and Allah loves you. Anytime you want anything, come to me and I'll give it to you. So the young man looks at him and says, I come to you? He said, yes, anytime you need anything, come to me. He said, well, I raised my hand to Allah in the middle of the night and you came to me. Why should I not raise my hand next time to Allah again and send you or he will send you or somebody else? إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدْ وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينَ. إِذَا سَأَلْتْ فَاسْأَلِ اللَّهِ وَإِذَا اسْتَعَنْتْ فَاسْتَعِنْ بِاللَّهِ. If you ask, ask Allah. And if you seek help from Allah. Allah will send people to help you. You don't have to ask. You don't have to ask. He will send people to you to help you. And when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends somebody to help us, what do we say? I was lucky today. I met a friend who helped me. No, it wasn't luck. It was tawfiq min Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It was Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala putting somebody to help us. Maybe because we prayed or somebody prayed for us to make it easy on us. So we remember, إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينَ. We seek, we tell Allah, we worship you, and we seek help from you, and be sure that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give us this help. And as we know, إِذَا سَأَلَكَ عَبَادِي عَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in the Quran, if you ask about Allah, He is close. He is close, أُجِيبُ دَعْوَةَ الدَّاعِي. He will answer the prayers. And it tells us in the Quran, أَمَّنْ يُجِيبُ الْمُضْطَرِّ إِذَا دَعَاهُ. Who answers those who need if they ask? And this muttar is not just a believer. Anybody. If he raised his hand to Allah, Allah will answer him. So when we say Iyyaka na'budu wa Iyyaka nasta'in, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says this is between me and my servant. And then we say ihdina as-sirata mustaqim. We ask Allah to guide us the straight path. This is the straight path that's going to make us happy in ad-dunya and in al-akhirah. It's not only to give us al-jannah. The straight path is to make us happy. The relation between us and our parents, with our children, with our spouses. This is the sirat al-mustaqim. We'll have that peace of mind in life, with our job, with our family, and we'll be successful in this life and then successful in the hereafter. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide us to, in the straight path. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَعَبْدِ مَا سَأَلْ I will answer my servant. And if we look, go further in the Quran, the next ayah in Surah in Surah Al-Baqarah, Alif Lam Mim, ذَلِكَ الْكِتَابُ لَا رَيْبَ فِيهُ هُدًى لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. This book, there is no doubt about it, guidance for those who observe Allah. So we ask Allah for the huda, the guidance, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala provides it to us, and He has given us the Quran as guidance. That Quran we read so quickly, we don't try to reflect on its meanings. It is guidance, it is cure, it is benefit for all of us. So we reflect, this is the guidance. We pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala every day, minimum 17 times, say, اهدنا الصراط المستقيم. Guide us to that straight path. But we say it and our mind is not there. Our mind is in ad-dunya, on our job, on our studies, on our children. And we don't focus that we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, اهدنا الصراط المستقيم. صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم, this is the way and the path of those that you have أنعمت عليهم, bless them. And if we want to know what أنعمت عليهم mean, we go in the Quran and says ومن يطع الله والرسول فأولئك مع الذين أنعم الله عليهم من النبيين والصديقين والشهداء والصالحين وحسن أولئك رفيقا. He who obeys Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His messenger, those are with those who has been blessed by Allah. Who are they? النبيين, the prophets, the siddiqeen, those siddiqs, the shuhada, the martyrs, the salihin, the good people, وحسن أولئك رفيقا, and they are good companions. These are the companions that we ask the straight path. صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم, not those that you are angry at, ya Allah, ولا الضالين, or those who were misguided. We ask Allah for the straight path. Those of al-Nabiyyin wa-Siddiqin wa-Shuhada, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide us on this path, insha'Allah. So here, insha'Allah, we read Al-Fatiha, we reflect on what it means, and we realize in time of trouble, it is shifa, it will prevent things, so we read it. But when we read it, we have to focus. We focus, just like Uthman ibn Affan said, هذه الفتحة أين عمر? This is الفتحة, but where is عمر? Because عمر used to believe, it will cure. So when you believe, inshallah it would, and it would, but we seek the cure, and then we read al-Fatiha, and inshallah it will cure us, inshallah. For al-Fatiha, as we said before, is the names of al-Fatiha is al-Hamd, thankful, because we say alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. It is shifa, the cure. Al-Waqiyah is the prevention. Al-Kafiyah, it's enough. Subhanallah, and asas al-Quran is the base of the Quran. This is Surah al-Fatiha that we read 17 times a day. Most of us read it absent-minded rather than focus. And when we say اهدنا الصراط المستقيم, know that this is the best prayer that we should ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for. And we ask it every day, but our mind is absent. We focus because this is where we all want to be, happy in this dunya and happy in the hereafter. And this is what is الصراط المستقيم that we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for in our prayers all the time.